वेलकम बैक सुमित।
यस,
इंडिया वन फाइनली।
या
सो व्हाट इज योर
बिफोर स्टार्टिंग लेट मी कॉल माइकल वॉक। हेलो हेलो वॉक, आ गया स्वाद। Yes, yes, please start.
Self-put. What was the assessment of the entire game? The performance of both the teams?
I think India totally outplayed, out-thought England. In second day, they were pretty on the top of the game for the first two sessions. India and England had equal chances. They could have won or we could have won from there. But then it was just a pure display of talent and temperament from our youngsters. So I think both the teams had equal chances. But then India grabbed the opportunity and showed why they are best in the world and why none other team more than India deserves to be in the final of World Test Championship. And yes, I think they won the ICC Championship match and they are first top of the table.
Correct. Yeah. Even I thought that England were in the game only on the second day, and that too on the first two sessions. After that, they look pretty flat. As I said earlier as well, that you know they don't think that they can win this series. So the first two sessions, they thought that they had a chance. Do you think they were a bowler short, according to you?
No, I don't think they were a bowler short. Even if they had Broad or Archer, the result would have been same.
I thought. Like lot of experts said that they were a seamer shot, but according to me, I think they were one spinner shot. Actually, Dominic Best should have been the one who should have performed, but he didn't. Mm-hmm. Obviously, he didn't have the confidence, so they actually missed Dominic Best. Had he performed well,
but they had no chance for any other spinner. Yeah,
For example, if they had Moeen Ali, the result could have been different. You never know. But I don't think so. It would have made much difference. I think India has enough quality to beat this team. And Spider-Man, according to you, how was his performance? Spider-Man,
yeah, he is absolutely brilliant. He is our superhero. So he was sweep of Anderson, that too on a new ball. That is unbelievable, I think. No one could have done it other than him.
Yeah,
and
continue.
And not just that, if you see his first half of the innings, he didn't play his natural game, that is attacking game. He played defensively. He assisted the pitch, what he told from his interview. He understood the pitch and grew his partnership with Rohit Sharma. And he rotated the strike pretty well. And once he completed 50, then from there he took on the bowlers and he took on Anderson and Stokes especially. And from there, there was no stopping him, and I think it was lucky for them to get him out. Otherwise, he could have gone to make a daddy 100.
Correct. Yeah, his maturity. In earlier part of his career, he was so much criticized about his maturity, that he's having a bad shot selection, is not really reading the game situation. But he's now, in the past 4 to 5 months, he's grown leaps and bounds. Right. He's starting to read game situation and he's starting to become a lot more mature as a batsman. I think these are great signs for Indian cricket team. Like we had Mahendra Singh Dhoni obviously, but we didn't really have someone who can score, a wicketkeeper batsman who can score centuries. Because of him, we are able to play 5 bowlers. So I think he's a great asset to have, and he's going to be a superstar. There's no doubt about it. It's just that how he handles now. The teams will come and. Now the teams will prepare for him in the next series, because I think given the fact that he scored the majority of the runs, he's second highest run scorer in 2021. overall in terms of batsman, and number one for India, highest run scorer for India in 2021 in Test. So that really speaks volumes of his performance, and I was really mighty impressed with his performance.
Yeah, correctly said. If you see, we were 150 for six down. And England, I believe, were on the top of the game. They could have easily contained us and got India all out on 200 or 220.
Less than 200, maybe.
But how our youngsters really showed what they're capable of, and that our future Indian cricket is in safe hands. They really showed that and displayed that day. It was quite brilliant. And I believe it was one of the best innings in 2021. And he has started the journey of becoming a match winner. Rishabh Pant.
Correct.
He's really a superhero. Yeah. He's a hot strike. If he could have been in a market, like a stocks, he could have been a hot strike.
And his commentary behind the stumps.
Yeah, exactly. And not just batting. If you saw his keeping throughout the series, he has improved immensely. Like he took some blinders in second and third match, and then doing keeping. Hello? Hello? Am I audible?
Yeah, continue. I lost between. Continue.
Yeah. And keeping two spinners on such track where it is turning a lot, and doing and stumping on such balls is quite brilliant. He did a brilliant job, and he has improved a lot. This is quite visible and evident that his hard work is paid off.
It's
not just batting, his keeping skill also. So I think he has grown as a cricketer and in all skill sets, in all the fields. And his comment in the terms is as famous as anything as his batting.
He keeps motivating
the players even when we are not getting wickets or morale is down and shoulders are dropped. But he just don't lose hope. He keeps motivating the players. He's a funny character.
And he brings that kind of vibe into the team as well. Even Virat Kohli mentioned in the press this post-match presentation that having a character like him really boosts the team, because in the first test the players were pretty flat in terms of body language, like the Indian players. And so somebody like Pant in the field is really he spreads joy basically, and he's got that. Funny character and funny attitude which rubs on the other players as well.
You could have seen 1-2 videos, or I think you have seen it live, that whenever the ball goes to any fielder and they are taking run, he makes funny noises and confuses a batsman. Yeah, crazy noises. He's like our local gully cricketer.
correct.
But if you remember, I told you before the series, we are definitely going to win this series. But because, just a funny fact, because this is a Paytm Trophy. Paytm Trophy and Virat Kohli, a better love story than Twilight.
he never looks under pressure in Paytm series, right? It's like Paytm, it's inevitable. Going to win the Paytm series. I don't
invincible.
Know what
in Paytm Trophy is very invincible.
Why is Paytm the only sponsor I get this? Why other
I think World Cup should be, I think instead of ICC it should be Paytm. A Paytm Trophy World Test Championship, Paytm Trophy World Cup.
Okay.
Moving on from the funny part. Yeah, did you Manoj Tiwari mentioned that now India looks the invincible side, like there were West Indies and Australia in the past. So what are your thoughts on that?
I don't think so. We are still invincible. I think there is still we are still fragile. Our batting, like we saw, our batting lineup is not really consistent enough. There is inconsistency from all players, like from Virat, except Rohit Sharma, he performed well in the series, but I think there is still improvement required in terms of batting Our bowling has been absolutely fine. I think we have done, we have taken 20 wickets right from 2018. Right from every from 2018, in every series, they have picked up 20 wickets in both the innings, like in every test. So that really shows that we have a good bowl. And it's not that same bowlers have taken wickets. The other bowlers, the reserve bowlers, have also picked wickets. So that really shows our bowling depth, but our batting depth is still, there's still a lot of improvement required there. I don't think we are invincible. Yes, we are a strong team right now as compared to the other teams. But I hope that the pending centuries come in World Test Championship final. I hope Virat Kohli scores there. But I don't want to keep any hopes from now. Because we won't talk. We won't jinx it.
The positive which I feel from which we got from past 3 months was now we are not dependent on our senior players, and especially not Virat Kohli and Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma. Everyone is contributing, and every now this seems like a team effort to me.
Yeah, in spite of despite our big players didn't score well, we still won, and we hammered them. Not just won it, but we hammered them totally. So that really proves, that shows
that has been the story of 2021.
that shows the quality of our side. We are, I think that is, as you rightly mentioned, that is a big positive to us. Like earlier, our team was totally dependent on Virat Kohli, and in white ball also, we had Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma, and we always looked at them to score runs. But now, even if they don't perform, we win games and we win them comprehensively. So that is a big positive. And, we had this issue in the past as well, where our lower order was not contributing, the lower batting order.
Exactly.
But now, with inclusion of
our lower batting order looks stronger.
With inclusion of Pant as a wicketkeeper batsman, and then youngsters like Sundar and all these players, Sundar and Shardul Thakur, and Jadeja has always been the one who's contributed, but he's also grown as a batsman as well. So these people really make our lower order really very strong. So it will be difficult for opposition teams to take 10 wickets against India, because we'll always have people who will...
Someone who is putting up,
Even if we score low, we have players who can... I can safely say that India can bat at least 90 overs in every innings, minimum. That is the kind of lineup that India.
Okay. Now let's move ahead to our analysis of the fourth and last very test match of the series. So my question was, so do you think when England were on the top in the on the second day, the first two sessions, did they miss the trick, and they could they have brought Jack Leach when Sundar and Pant were batting, and when Pant just crossed 50, because I think they give overs to Leach till the point when Ashwin was batting, and once the Ashwin got out, they just made bowling changes.
It is a cliche, right? Like whenever the left-handers are batting, don't give the bowling to left-arm spinners. That is a stupid cliche that we have in cricket. And I don't know what is the... I mean, I understand the logic behind it, but it doesn't really work. When you are having a scarcity of bowlers, you have to give your best spinner. And the spinners were quite effective. Although Ben Stokes and Anderson bowled pretty much well. But you still want to give your best bowlers more overs, right? And given the fact that you just have two seamers, so you have to rotate them. So you have to bowl a spinner at one end. And it was Root who was bowling instead of Jack Leach. So I think they underbowled Jack Leach. That was the tactical error that he made. But I don't think so it would have made much difference, because the kind of batting that Sundar and Pant were doing was incredible. So I don't think so Jack Leach would have made much difference. Yes, he might have contained few runs. He might have bowled few deliveries which would have made run scoring a little bit difficult. But I think no. It was a tactical error. But especially when they made a mistake, especially when Pant was on 96 and Root came from the other end. I think that is where he made a mistake. He could have given Jack Leach the ball, because there was a contest between Jack Leach and Pant, right from the start of the series.
Exactly.
So Jack Leach, and Jack Leach had picked his wicket in the previous test match, Pant's wicket. So I think Root shouldn't have bowled that over. It should have been Jack Leach, but as I said, it wouldn't have made much difference.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, if you see Jack Leach have grown in confidence over the period of time in this series. So I think, yes, it could have been a good contest if they would have brought Jack Leach instead of Dominic Bess or Root. Because Dominic Bess gave one or two bad balls. He bowled full tosses. In each over, he bowled one or two full tosses, which gave freedom to our batsman to rotate strike and score two or two boundaries per over. So it released the pressure of our batsmen. And it didn't really look like their off spinners are putting pressure on our left-handed batsmen. So I think, yes, they could have tried Jack Leach because he had that confidence and he had that momentum. So I think, and also on that part of the wicket, there was marks, foot marks and cracks as well. Yeah, it was spinning from there. So he could have tried making him play the shots and that might could have got them punch wicket earlier. So that could have been a possibility. That could have been a possibility. But yeah, but I also agree with you that yes, as we are Indian fans, that we as an Indian fan, we know that he could have
he could have created few chances, but
few chances friend.
In hindsight, it will look like a tactical error, but I think it wouldn't have made much difference.
Yeah, that was the only possibility how they could have tackled him.
How they could have managed the
managed him or contained him or managed to get his wicket. Other than that, it was absolutely brilliant. There was no chance for England to get into the game once he got going. I think that partnership and punt inning won us the match. First punt inning, because that gave us the momentum, and then Sundar's inning. Those two innings won us the match and the series. Correct.
And I thought Anderson and Stokes bowled their hearts out. I think I haven't seen seamers for a while. The opposition spinners, seamers, bowl so well in Indian conditions. And Anderson he's been criticized in the past for his bowling, that he just takes wickets at home conditions, but he's proved in this series that that's not the case. He can bowl in Asian conditions as well. So credit where it is due. I think Stokes bowled exceptionally. He bowled better than Anderson. And Anderson, he bowled, I think, 27 overs and picked up 3 wickets, and his economy was 1.76. So you can imagine how much runs he had contained as a bowler, and also picked up wickets. And Ben Stokes had bowled around 24 overs and he had picked 4 wickets. So I think these two did the bulk of the job. If these two hadn't played well, England was not in the game at all. England would not have been in the game at all. So because of their effort, I think England came back into the game. They got a glimpse of hope that they might win this game. But I think, good performance from both of them, I think.
Stokes really bowled well on the second day. I think the ball on which he got wicket of Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma, it was a good top ball, because you need to get those balls to get wicket of best batsmen in the world. Otherwise, I think Rohit Sharma could have also went to make a century.
Correct. Yeah, he would have taken the game in the one session itself.
And you don't see world's best batsman getting out on duck. You need some good balls, exceptional balls for those.
That's a different topic.
That's an arguable topic. But I think that ball was really that it bounced a little bit more than he expected.
Do you think BCCI needs to arrange a havan for
I think there should be some Panoti Nikal Havan.
Ravi Shastri should be sitting at the front of the
especially thing. Now we would be playing final on 18th June. Before then, we should have that havan and get some Panoti out.
before that, as usual, we have IPL. Before every major tournament or series, we have IPL. So,
Parampara, Pratishtha. I hope. Yeah. I hope no one gets injured. Please give rest to players wherever necessary, whenever necessary.
They had WTC in mind, World Test Championship. Mm-hmm. That is why BCCI released the schedule of IPL today, right? They were waiting for the result of yesterday's game so that they understand whether they
are. I think final is on 23rd May, and they then get some rest.
23rd or 30th? Is it
23rd? 23rd, yeah.
I thought
in Ahmedabad.
Oh, okay. So they have around 2 weeks time before the 3 weeks time. 1 week will go in quarantine, so they have 2 weeks time before.
But I want finals to be in lots. But they are planning now. England board is planning to shift. Yeah, depends on the COVID situation. But I want it to be lots because we want to take a revenge from New Zealand of 2019 World Cup. I want to see that trophy in Lord's balcony.
It's not going to be a World Test Championship.
Yeah. First, do some havan or something.
Because we are jinxed.
We always get out on knockout games in semi-finals or finals.
team combination is going to be a mystery now. Talking
about team combination, my next question was on that. So, do you think Sundar could fit in our main playing 11 once our full strength team is back, and should he play in England?
It depends on the pitch conditions and both the availability of all our players. I don't think so. He'll be a short pick. If Jadeja comes back, then I don't think so he will be picked, because he's right now used as a batting all-round, right? So Jadeja gives you that batting. So I don't think so Sundar will be picked. Yes, he'll be in the contention. There's no doubt about it. He's a very exciting talent to have. I think he's elegant and he's got that compact technique. But what impresses me the most about him is his temperament, his composure with which he bats. I think that is what you look into a player. If you want to judge a player, you look whether he's able to perform in difficult situations or not, and whether he's able to pull out the team from difficult situations and win games for the team. And he's done it thrice in 4 test matches. He's done already 3 times that. So that really speaks volumes of his character. So he, if he had played for some other team, let's say if he was playing in New Zealand, he would have been in the playing 11, short. But because he's an Indian player, so there is contention in playing 11. But I don't think so they'll pick him. Unless Jadeja or Ashwin, one of these gets injured, I don't see him playing. In fact, it depends totally on the pitch. If the pitch is seeming, then I don't think India will play 2 spinners. They'll go with 1 spinner and 4 seamers. Depends on the conditions. I think India might go with Jadeja and Ashwin. And if any one of these gets injured, then Sundar will play. Other than that, I don't see him playing the final. What do you think?
Okay, but I think Jadeja will come in the place of Akshar Patel. So,
yeah.
and they might see to replace Sundar with Hardik Pandya if he's fit for bowling. Mm-hmm. But if he's not confident about his bowling, then I think they should go with Sundar, because he's conventional batsman. He plays proper cricketing shot with straight bat, and that's what is needed in England in the seeming conditions. And he gives that extra assurance to the top order and the middle order that even if we lose wickets, we have players down the line who will contribute with the bat. And also he can contribute with the ball, as we know. So I think, we should seriously consider him in the playing 11.
Because we'll have 3 spinners, right? Then the combination would be weird.
If we don't wish to go with extra seamer, then he won't be able to find a place.
Even if there was a series coming next in India, I think the combination.
But what do you think? Who would replace Sundar, like Hardik Pandya? Because Jadeja would come in for Akshar Patel.
I think they'll play a seamer in. I think Mohammad Shami will come in. Bumrah, Shami, and
Ishan. Okay, three seamers. And then Jadeja and Ashwin. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because Jadeja gives you batting.
That makes sense.
Okay. That's why They are using him as a batting all-rounder. That's what I'm trying to say. They are not using him as a
batting all-rounder.
Did we touch upon all the topics? No, we are still left, right?
No, my last question, then you can ask if you have any. My last question would be, do you see fitting one left-hander in the top five and playing one left-hander at five ahead of Ajinkya Rahane and then playing Ajinkya Rahane on sixth number?
Yeah, I mean, if you talk just about Sundar.
Sundar or any, Rishabh Pant or Sundar, anyone, but just to have a left-hander at five.
Depends on the match situation, to be very honest. You know, it depends totally on the match situation. If let's say we are 39 for 3, for example, then I think playing Ajinkya Rahane would be a lot more safer because he's got that game to, you know, steady the ship. But let's say if we are batting in the fourth innings, or maybe if you're batting, if we need someone who can instill confidence in the side, like someone who can come and attack the opposition, then you will think of playing Rishabh Pant. I don't think so. It should be a set batting order where you play Rishabh Pant at five and Ajinkya at six. In fact, it is a good luxury to have that we can have a batting order according to the situation, given the lineup that we have right now. We can also push Sundar at five, maybe play him at six, depending upon the situation. But I think, yes, it should not be a rigid batting order. But yeah, it could be an option in the future matches. What do you think?
Yeah, adding to your thoughts, I think sometimes seamers or any bowler is comfortable bowling to right-handers. That's what we saw in the first test of Australia series, the one in which we got out on 36, we got all out on 36. Because they were swinging ball and they were pretty much comfortable bowling to right-handers. And I think everyone we had in team were right-handers in the first test. We didn't play Rishabh Pant or Sundar in that test. So I think sometimes it's important to give a change. Yeah, like you said, if you are three down or four down early in the innings, then we should, instead of sending Ajinkya Rahane, we can send Pant just to counter attack and to change the line and length of the bowler. So,
In fact, I said the contrast of what you said. I said the opposite of what you said. But I think it makes more sense what you said, right? What I was saying is if India is 39 for 3 or 40 for 3, then I thought
Ajinkya would be better.
But yeah, you can send Pant, but it could be risky also. Because Pant
you can send Pant or Sundaraya. It will be a risky move, but that would be a tactical move to just counter the and to change the line of length of the bowler. So he has to then again change or he has to change the side and also he has to change the line and length.
And given the New Zealand's bowling lineup, I think it will be better if we play at the top.
Yeah. And that also gives us ice and fire combination if Pujara and Pant are playing. That's what we saw. They weren't comfortable bowling to left-handers. And the line they bowl to right-handers, the same line with the same line and length they came on the left-handers, and that just contributed to the form of left-handers.
I think we have this issue where we get collapse, and Pant is the only solution I can think of if we want to stop a collapse. So it makes sense. I agree with you. Yeah, I think I agree with you because
we should think of adjusting some here and there and making one left-handed up the order to move one left-handed
because if they are in rhythm, then it makes a lot more sense
to break the rhythm and cool down the situation on the field.
Correct, absolutely. The only issue that I think of right now with India is their batting inconsistency that we have and. What do you think Kohli should do differently to? I don't know. I mean, it's very difficult to analyze his batting right now because we are not really able to understand what's going wrong with him. Because if we look at him, his technique is absolutely fine. He's not really looking weak in his technique, technique wise. But I don't know. What do you think? What is your analysis?
I also don't know. If I keep on thinking and then it would give me sleepless nights to figure out what is the real reason. I have to design some algorithm or something. Because the only solution I see is Havan. I do some puja and all. Because I see he is getting caught on extraordinary balls, or I don't know what is it. And is it something he is, yeah. He's getting unlucky at times.
Yeah, you could say unlucky. You could say,
and I think he's getting more aggressive on field, but that aggressiveness is not reflecting in his batting.
That's what I was trying to say. What is happening is, I think he's overthinking in his mind. He's mm-hmm. lot more thinking about technique. Virat Kohli, in the past we have seen him. He's an impulsive character, right? He's someone who comes in the crease and starts to stamp authority on the crease. So he's not doing that. He's a little cautious when he comes mm-hmm. when he plays the first 20-30 balls. I don't know. I think he's not like he's not busy on the crease. He's just stationary. That is a lot more static, you could say, on the crease. That is what I feel. He should be a little busier. Take more singles, you know, rotate strikes so that I don't know.
Correct.
That is only thing that I think is an issue. But as you said in the previous episode, that if he scores one, then that all these difficulties will go away. It's just short of confidence in terms one of runs. So let's hope that these runs do come. I don't know when they'll come. We cannot predict. We've been terribly bad at our predictions the last episode. I don't want to throw myself wrong in the future again. I won't predict anything.
No expectations. Whenever we keep no expectations, that's when we are surprised. That's when he surprises us.
That's when the entire Indian team surprises us. That is the point.
Exactly. I think he should go more with his instincts, and yes, rightly said, he's too cautious these days. He's not that free flowing.
Exactly. Nowadays. Yeah, that is what I was trying to say. There is no rhythm to his batting. He's lost that kind of rhythm where he gets into that mindset where he's totally in that zone and he starts sitting
back. I hope this IPL brings that rhythm and form back.
When was the last time you saw him hit a cover drive? I haven't seen him hit a cover drive for quite a while.
Yeah.
In this entire season, he's not hit one single cover drive.
Whenever he tried to play cover drive, he got out of the spinner. If you see Dominic Best ball and Mohin Ali's ball. In both the instances, he went to play cover drive and
that is the reason.
There is the grace in his batting. Yeah. There was a grace in his cover drive.
But it is good. We are not really relying on it.
Now they will, now these experts, so-called experts and fans will come up telling that Babar Azam is better than Virat Kohli, and they will play his cover drive videos again and again. I don't want that. I badly need Virat Kohli to play.
Pakistan needs to learn how to arrange organized tournaments. They recently PSL got postponed, right? So stop comparing with players first. I learn to organize your tournaments first. I think Dale Steyn thinks that.
Exactly. I was getting to that point. PSL is greater than IPL. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Hai bande ko pyar, paise se pyar nahi hai.
No, he was not. Usko diya nahi tha na. He got kicked from.
But he is a legend. Yeah, he's a legend.
Absolutely.
But he's a good
boy. It must be different. You can have a difference in opinion. I mean, he must have felt better in that tournament. We cannot comment.
But slightly, he was right that he players get overshadowed in IPL because there is a lot of talent.
But it depends on your. It depends on the player's perspective. It depends on the player's perspective. Anyhow,
he wasn't that effective in T20. I don't know why.
I mean, yeah, he's lost his. He's lost his fire. He's lost his pace as well. But coming back, just one last question to wrap this up. Do you think ICC should have had 3 matches in the final rather than having just 1 test match? Because test matches can be condition dependent as well. So I think they should have had 3 test matches. What do you think on this issue?
till yesterday, I didn't know. I had the same confusion whether in finals we have the whole series or just one match. I asked my one friend. He asked me back the same question. So I was confused and I googled and I saw that there is only just one match that on 18th June, and I don't think that makes sense as an Indian fan, because अपने को आदत है कि first match हारने का to get the rhythm. That's a whole story of 2021, and actually for the past 4 to 5 series, that is the story for years. Indian cricket. Yeah, we lose the first match of the series, and then we come back strongly. Then how will we manage to win World Test Championship? I think it should be 3-match series. That's when I am concerned about winning the final. Now we need to seriously look into it, or they should play some practice match before playing the final.
In fact, New Zealand has an advantage because they have a series before that World Test final. They have a series with England, so they have
one. We somehow managed to go for and in the first match.
we don't have good record against New Zealand in ICC tournament.
That's another thing. Yes,
but according to me, it will be like completing the arc. Like we, when you look at the entire journey of our team in the World Test Championship, we have won against West Indies overseas. We won against Australia. We have won against South Africa. We won against Bangladesh. We've also won against England now. So the only team
lost against.
Against New Zealand, so it is a fitting end to a journey, you could say.
Yeah.
So if we defeat them, then others will say that World Test Championship happened between a pandemic and most of the teams didn't get chance to play their matches. But that is just noise. That is just outside noise. That's just excuse, and they're just jealous of the Indian team because we have, in spite of being number one, we lost our position because of this percentage points that they brought.
Mm-hmm.
And in spite of
moment changes.
We have managed to qualify for finals. So I think we deserve. If we beat New Zealand, I think we deserve. We deserve to have this championship, and we are the number one team. Let's go.
Yeah, we deserve it more than any other team. I think we are the best team side on paper and as well as on field now.
Are you excited for the T20 series?
Yeah. It starts on 12th March, right? Is T20 series also a Paytm series?
Obviously. Paytm
no
is
tension,
India.
No tension, we will win that. No tension. No worries. No need of any puja, nothing. It is his favorite trophy. Virat Kohli's favorite trophy.
So when ICC will write history about Virat Kohli's captaincy, Paytm will be in brackets.
Yeah. The cover page should be of Paytm. The logo should be of Paytm.
Yeah. Even the jersey sponsor should have been Paytm. If Paytm
I think
is
Paytm should
us.
Be the sponsor of Royal Challengers Bangalore. I think then they would win a title. Their first title.
Let's have a separate episode for RCB. Instead of talking here.
So let's come back before our T20 series.
T20 series, we'll do one episode.
Okay.
Good talking to you.
Yeah.
Yeah.